Administrator, thank you for being here. I'm not sure how many people I'd wish that job on. That's a tough job that you've stepped into, and you've inherited an awful lot of disasters that are going on, as the ranking member noted earlier. I want to flag a few things for you. Number one, the Disaster Recovery Reform Act that became law in 18 and bipartisan bill that many members in this committee worked on. It had a provision in there related to rebuilding of schools and other public facilities. There's under Stafford Act, it says that each facility that floods, is to have a $500,000 deductible. The way that FEMA has applied that is they have applied that $500,000 facility, which I view as being in a school. They've applied it to a storage shed, they've applied it to a gymnasium, they've applied it to the elementary school building, they've applied it to the middle school building, they've applied it to the high school building, they've applied it to the cafeteria. So all of a sudden, what would have been a $500,000 payment that I think Congress intended in Stafford has become, who knows, an $8 million payment. Many of our schools get their funds from property taxes. Properties have been destroyed during the flood, so you can just see this whole cascading effect. So in that bill, Congress enacted a change that made it clear it was $500,000 per facility, period, for a school, for a jail, whatever it is. That was law over a year ago. We have schools that still have not been rebuilt from our August 2016 flood because FEMA has not changed their rules. They have not implemented this law that was put in place over a year ago. So we have children that are being affected. We have schools that are doubling up. We have temporary buildings. We have schools that are literally in the same shape they were in before because they can't afford to rebuild them because they can't afford the deductible. Could you please make this a priority and fix this? The law is crystal clear. I think the law was clear before. Now it's even more clear, if that's possible. Would you please make this a priority and get this fixed as soon as possible?
Yes, sir. And I'll look into the specifics of how we have applied it in actual, right down to the local and county and state level. I don't know enough detail about how we're actually applying it, but you have my commitment that I'll get you feedback and we'll compare what the law says and how we're applying it, and we'll work towards making sure that we...
Thank you. Administrator, I don't think there's any argument over what the law says. Actually, Congress has stepped in and done the same thing in the past for past disasters whenever FEMA has applied, and again, in my opinion, inappropriately applied Stafford. So there's nobody who should be reinventing the wheel. You can cut and paste what you've done in the past and just apply it here. Second issue, just because I'm burning time here. Second issue, we also included a provision in there that I think was very well thought out, bipartisan support, that says that FEMA should get together with the Federal Highway Administration and develop standards for evacuation routes. And the reason is because in the event of disasters, we have found that many of our evacuation routes are inundated or otherwise impassable. Now, you think about that for a minute. If our evacuation routes are impassable, that's a big deal. In our August 2016 flood, the interstate barrier between the east and west lane actually served as a levee. We needed levees, not there. Which exacerbated flooding to the tune of 6 and in some cases maybe as high as 8 feet higher inundation on the north side of the interstate. And so it actually created victims because the people couldn't get off the interstate. They were stuck on these little interstate islands. We had to fly helicopters to drop food and supplies to them. It was ridiculous. So we put a provision in and said, hey, get with Federal Highway Administration, develop the right standards. Nothing has been changed on this interstate, nothing. Would you please look into this and make this a priority? There was some very tenuous guidance that was issued that didn't even come close to hitting the mark on this. So would you please look into this and make sure that this works?
I will, sir.
All right, last question. I'm going to guess that if you did work and you didn't receive a paycheck for a couple of years, that would probably make it very difficult on you. I don't know if you're married, but your spouse, your family. We have contractors in Louisiana that have done work in the Virgin Islands. Look, I know we can point fingers at everybody. We can point fingers at the companies. We can point fingers at the USVI government. You can point fingers at me. I don't care. administrator, this is not okay. You're losing your disaster response capabilities across the United States. You're going to be limited to having two big companies left. They're going to gouge you on prices. This is not in your interest. Would you please step in and provide some leadership and address this? I yield back.
Yes, sir.